Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Paul from TechLink, and in today's video I want to show you how to take a screenshot of an entire web page on an iPhone. Now most of you guys are probably familiar with the screenshot function. All I know is I use it a lot, especially for sharing images and text with my contacts, and I recently discovered that you can actually take a full page screenshot of the web pages you are browsing, so wanted to share it with you. So the first thing you have to do is, guess what? Take a screenshot. If you don't know how to do that, well, you have to press the power on button and the volume up at the same time, and you have to quickly release them. Don't hold them press, as your iPhone will go into the emergency mode. And now you will see this small thumbnail on the left corner of your screen, on which you can tap on and edit it and save it to your photos. So to get back to the topic of this video, let's say you want to take a screenshot of a whole web page. You need to go to Safari, open the page that you want to save and take a screenshot. Now normally when you do this, you only get to capture what's on your screen, but if you take a screenshot and tap on this thumbnail, you will see that you now have two tabs to choose from: the screen or the full page. So we're gonna go and select full page, and what happens here is you're gonna get a full preview of the page you want to save, and you can mark it up just like you would do on a normal screenshot, or you can scroll down from this sidebar right here and navigate through the whole page. Now this is a really great feature if you're reading a book or some article and you want to highlight something, you can easily do that. And once you are done, you can share it or save it as an image. Now bear in mind that if you want to do that, unlike a normal screenshot which would be saved as a photo in your gallery, this will be saved as a PDF file. So if you press done, it will prompt you to save this as a PDF into your files. So just press save. You then get to choose the location where you want to save it, let's say on my iPhone, and press save again. So to access your web page screenshot, instead of going to your photos gallery, you need to go to your files, and in here you can browse to the location where you saved your screenshot, open it, and you'll see it's the exact same page that you previously saved. Another thing worth mentioning is that this feature is fairly limited at the moment. I tried it with several other native apps and it wouldn't work. Even the web pages can only be screenshot in Safari, so if you're using another browser, it won't work. The only place that I could find that would let me take a full page screenshot is in another PDF file. So you can do that if you want to, let's say, crop a few pages off of it. And that's it for today's video. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. Also, if you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up or share it with someone you think might benefit from it. And if you would like to see some similar tutorials, please subscribe to the channel. And like always, thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.